Okay, class, today we're going to learn the Greek alphabet. Now, what I'm going to be pronouncing, though, is not modern Greek, it's Koine Greek, which I've been told the New Testament was written in. It was the language of the time. And so my pronunciations might differ from modern pronunciations of the different letters. But I was working with my kids one time, and I thought, how could I teach them the Greek alphabet? And here's what I came up with, so maybe it'll work for you. Ready? But you got to work with me. So when I say repeat after me, because hopefully in about 8 minutes, you'll be able to say the Greek alphabet. So the word alphabet comes from the first two letters of the Greek alphabet, which are alpha and beta. So repeat after me, alpha, beta.
Alpha, beta.
And then we have the third one, which is gamma. So alpha, beta, gamma.
Alpha, beta, gamma.
So you got to remember those. I was hoping you'd know those already. Alpha, beta, gamma. Now, the next one is you have to pretend that you can visualize a jet. So I'll do some motions to trigger your mind, okay? So this is a jet, and it happens to be a delta jet. So when I go like this, it's what?
Delta.
And this particular jet has a name on the side of it. Have you ever seen some jets like Southwest Air has the Lone Star jet? Okay, this is the Epsilon jet, okay? So this is delta. The name of the jet is Epsilon. Let's try the first five now. We've got alpha, beta, gamma, delta, epsilon. Okay. So you're flying on this delta jet named Epsilon, and you're up into the air, and you've turned off all your electronic devices, and then they bring food around. And the food that they're going to give you is called a? No. It's a theta, T-H, theta, theta. But there was one passenger who was so tall and large that they didn't fit in the plane, so they put them out on the wing. So you got to pretend you can visualize this delta jet named Epsilon with this large person named Zeta. Zeta. It was actually a lady, okay? Her name is Zeta. And so the stewardess opened up the exit hatch and reached out and gave her a theta. So Zeta, eta, theta. Got it? Okay. So zeta, eta, theta. So let's try from all the way to the beginning. Alpha, beta, gamma, delta, epsilon, zeta, eta, theta. Okay? Now, where the plane was going, it was flying to Cincinnati. And her husband that picked her up at the airport in his big pickup truck, it had to be a big truck, Her husband's name was Iota. Now, some people say Iota, but it's Iota, like a short I, Iota. And he's a tall, slender fellow. And so Iota, and he tries to put his arm around Zeta when she lands, all happy to see her. And Iota had this really nice hat, a little kappa. All right, so let's try this now. We're on the plane again. Let's just skip to the plane. What's the lady's name? Zeta. Eta, theta, her husband, Iota, with a kappa. So he greets Zeta at the airport, and they get into the pickup truck, and they ride back. They build kind of a farm, and they raise little lambdas. But the lambdas are a little bit learning disoriented, and they think they're cows. And the noise that they make is moo, noo, okay, like M-O. O and N-O-O, moo, nu, which by the way, we're down here now. Iota, kappa, lambda, moo, nu. All right, so what's her name? Zeta, eta, theta. Her husband? Iota, kappa, raised little lambdas that said moo, nu. So the sun was going down, and Iota and Zeta are out in the field, and they're looking at the little lambdas. But then they start staring into each other's eyes, and they lost track of the lambdas, and the lambdas got out in the cornfield. And all of a sudden, he noticed that they'd broken free, and they were out, and the queen said, "Ksi? Oh, my corn!" Okay, now, ksi is like a K-S-I sound. Ready? Ksi. Ksi. Omicron. But it's pretty close to Omicron, okay? So it's Omicron. Xi, Omicron. Okay, so now let's start with the little lambdas. The little lambdas say, Mu. Nu. Xi. Oh, my corn. Okay. Now, we're down here. We've already covered 14 letters. Now, we're in Cincinnati. I'm dating myself now, but one of the most famous Cincinnati Reds from Major League Baseball history was, try, Pete Rose. Pete Rose, and that comes to our next letters, which is P, which we often say pi. This is where we get pi r squared. But P, rho. It looks like a P, but it's actually an R sound, P, rho. And that's Pete Rose. He was a great hitter. Ended up playing with the Phillies a little bit, all right? So, see? Oh, my corn. And then they got all the little lambdas back in the pasture. They wanted to go see the Reds play a game that night. So they get back in the pickup truck, and they go to the game, and there's their favorite player, P. Rowe. He had a baseball cap on with a sigma up on the top. A sigma. All right? So P. Rowe, sigma. So it was a great game, and they even got invited down to the locker room to maybe meet some of the players, and they saw P. Rowe, with his sigma on his hat, walk along into towards the showers with a, what we have over his shoulder if he's going to the showers? A towel. Towel. But he slipped, and he went, oopsalon. So with the towel, oopsalon. Okay, so let's try from here again. See? Omicron. Who's this? P, rho, with a sigma, tau, upsilon. Okay, so let's go back to here. And this was Xi, omicron, P, rho, sigma, tau, upsilon. Okay, then the worst part of a ball game is having to pay the parking attendant when you leave. But the parking attendant decided to give them a break because they were such a happy couple. And so he said, when they asked him, what's our fee? He said, keepsy. So fee, the money they owed him, keepsy, like PSI, like pounds per square inch, except it's PSI. Okay, so fee, keepsy, and then omega, and we're done. So let's try from the beginning. You ready? First three letters. Alpha, beta, gamma, delta, epsilon, zeta, eta, theta. Her husband? Iota, kappa, lambdas, mu, nu, xi, omicron, p, rho, sigma, tau, upsilon, phi, chi, psi, omega. Very good.